The Cardinal Principles. By now in your studies, you should have already been exposed to these basic rules of thumb regarding radiation protection, but let's talk about why. NCRP report number 116 states, all personnel should stand at least 2 meters away from the X-ray tube and patient, or 6 feet. Again, the term should designates this as a recommendation, as it may not always be possible to distance yourself this far depending on what's going on in the examination. Let's review the cardinal principles of radiation protection taught during the early stages in your education. Time. Minimize the amount of time you're in proximity to the radiation source. Distance. Maximize the distance between you, the occupational worker, and the source of radiation. Shielding. Always use optimal shielding to protect yourself from exposure. The practice of keeping your time minimal and distance maximized should seem routine to you by now in clinical practice. But let's dive into some detailed reasons for these, as well as some practical tips regarding shielding. Keep in mind that the majority of occupational exposure is received from scatter radiation, which follows the same laws as the primary beam in regards to all three of these relationships. You may recall this experiment from your exposure principles lab where an abdomen phantom was placed on the X-ray table, and then we exposed the abdomen phantom using various techniques while placing different phantoms at distances in increments of approximately 6 feet away from the abdomen. This shows evidence that even though the primary beam wasn't used, the scatter radiation coming from the patient was enough to penetrate some of the smaller phantoms and provide an X-ray image on our CR cassettes behind them. Knowing this, the patient can be considered a source of scatter radiation, and the inverse square law principle applies to intensity of scatter coming from the patient and its relationship to distance. We discuss many aspects of reduction of patient exposure, but keep in mind the patient is not working around the radiation 40 hours a week, 50 weeks a year. Every small safety precaution you can take as occupational workers will dramatically influence your cumulative, lifelong exposure that can have the potential to produce effects. During fluoroscopic cases, we can take additional precautions by attaching the protective lead equivalent curtain. As you may discover in the lab section of this course by taking real-time measurements of dose with and without the curtain, let's talk about the isoexposure curves produced by the fluoroscope. Isoexposure curves identify the amount of scattered radiation coming from the patient in proximity to the fluoroscope when operating. Obviously, the same factors affecting your X-ray beam, such as size of the patient, presence of water, pathology, age, etc., will also have an effect on these curves. We can use them to identify best place for the fluoroscopist to stand to receive the least amount of radiation exposure. We use the curves to demonstrate radiation dose with and without a protective lead curtain attached to the fluoroscope. As you can see in image A on the right, without a protective curtain, the fluoroscope produces the following isoexposure pattern, with the output intensity of the fluoroscope measured in grays in the air. At 1 foot from the tabletop, 5 grays per hour. 2 feet measures 1 gray per hour, and 3 feet, a half a gray per hour. When a protective curtain is added, as in image B and the image on the left, the exposure at 1 foot is now only half a gray per hour. When readings are taken at a 90-degree angle to the patient, it reaches as low as 0.01 milligray per hour, and at the foot end of the table, around 5 milligray per hour. We can practice the cardinal principles during fluoroscopy more safely, being aware of isoexposure patterns. And the safest spots to stand during fluoroscopic procedures, but in practical scenarios in the clinical environment, the radiologist will likely be closest to the fluoroscope, meaning directly behind the lead drape. Keep this in mind as you position yourself in the room. Yes, there may be times when you need to assist the patient when the fluoro is live, but when you're not needed, you should be utilizing the additional lead shielding provided by the radiologist and his or her lead apron, as well as taking advantage of the isoexposure pattern of the fluoroscope by standing immediately behind them. Just make sure to have a visual line of sight of the patient in case you're needed for patient care and need to step in. Remember, it's the radiologist's responsibility during these procedures to capture the images needed. It's your responsibility to care for the patient primarily. Don't allow yourself to be distracted by the image so much that you lose sight of the patient.